guys, today I'm going to show you how to paint stripes on textured walls. I have a good trick that really helps to prevent bleed through, because painting stripes on textured walls isn't always the easiest, but if you do this little trick, it's pretty much guaranteed you're going to have a nice line when it's all over and done with. So, as you can tell, I've already taped off my wall where I'm painting the stripes. So I'm going to show you, I'll just do this little section here, and you can see. So first thing I'm going to do, you start with your base color, and you can see this wall is white. So, because I want white stripes as one of the colors that I'm doing. So I am going to, you take your base color of your wall and just put a little bit on your paintbrush. And then you're kind of just going to dry brush along the tape edges, like this. Let me cut this side. So you'll just do this. And this is going to seal in the color. So when you go over with your other color, it's not going to bleed through. So this essentially just seals everything in. Don't get too much on it, because you don't want the tape to get sopping wet or anything. So you're just going to do this on all areas of the sections that you're going to paint. Is just dry brush your base color on over the tape, and that's it. Then you're ready to roll on your color. So I'll come back for that. Okay, so I've dry brushed all of my stripes like I just showed you how to do, and now I'm really ready to roll on the paint color. Just be sure, whenever you're done rolling on the last coat of the color that you're doing, you need to remove the tape immediately and then just pull away from the wall. So just be sure you want, when the paint is still wet, you want to take off your tape then. So I'm going to roll on the color. And it's pink. So I'm going to do this for all of the stripes, and then I'll be back to peel off the tape for you. Okay, so I'm done painting the pink color on the wall for the stripes. This pink color, by the way, is Sherwin-Williams Dragon Fruit. It's a beautiful, bright, vibrant pink, and my daughter loves it. So my paint is still very wet, and so that's the best time to remove your tape, so you get the best line. So now let's see if I know what I'm talking about, and see if my theory works with that dry brushing. And I know that the dry brushing is an extra step, but it's a very important step. It's really a no-brainer. You really need to do it. So let's see. Looking good. Still looking good. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off here and finish removing it. So yeah, the line looks really good. I do have a couple of little spots right here that you would want to touch up with just a little brush, but for the most part, it's pretty great. So I'll zoom in on that. I've zoomed in right here so you can see that the line looks great. And here is the little part I was talking about, that you had a little bit of bleed through, but really minimal. The line is nice and crisp. It's really amazing that dry brushing, what that does. So our walls are very textured too, and it's unfortunate, but I have to live with it. So yeah, I'm very pleased with this, and I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you.